Welcome to CaseWare QuickVids. This QuickVid briefly demonstrates the functionality of do-it-yourself tables in financials to create unique and modifiable table formats. Do-it-yourself table formats allow you to customize the look and functionality of a table. Do-it-yourself table formats enable you to insert and delete columns, specify column type attributes, modify reporting period characteristics, create your own custom column calculation, access the CaseView table and cell property dialogs, customize table headings, as well as all of the following listed on screen. DIY tables can be created in statements, schedules, notes to the financial statements, and additional statement areas. Accordingly, the DIY tables can be created in these firm libraries. Each DIY table consists of CaseView cells and paragraphs that are organized easily into formattable rows and columns. Do-it-yourself tables utilize advanced calculations and automations. Thus, some CaseView functionality is unavailable in these tables. The two main areas in the do-it-yourself table where you will make the most customizations include the header line areas and the numeric columns. The remaining area allows for the selection of the data type, grouping number where applicable, and the description for each row. The customization of do-it-yourself table rows uses the same options available in all financials tables and includes creating titles, subtotals, and underlines. Using Financials IFRS, this QuickVid will demonstrate DIY tables from a firm author perspective. This video will cover how to create DIY tables and notes in the firm libraries and will explain how to edit and lock DIY tables before providing users with a custom template. We'll start by creating a DIY table in a statement area and then move on to creating DIY notes. To create do-it-yourself content as the firm author, open the Master Templates Firm Library document for the area in which you want to add the content. From the Document Manager, open CL Organization Standards or the equivalent. Since I want to add DIY content to my Additional Statement Area 1, I will click the Knowledge Library, then Additional Statement Area 1, which opens up the Firm Library. Navigate to the Document menu, then select Add New Firm Content. The Knowledge Library dialog opens. In the dialog, look for the available content with the suffix do-it-yourself in its name. Depending on the financial statement area, there may be several content options available. Note that some of the content will also offer different reporting periods, such as quarterly, based on your engagement properties setup. To find the DIY content, I will have to expand Additional Statement Area 1 and then Do-It-Yourself Statements until I can click the radio button beside the Do-It-Yourself Statement option. Here, I have a preview of the Do-It-Yourself Statement that I am about to insert. Click OK to add the content to the Financial Statement area. In the Choose the Category dialog that appears, select the relevant category for the DIY content, which in this case will be the default Do-It-Yourself Statements. The DIY content appears in the Firm Library document. You can now edit, customize, and manage the DIY table, which we will touch upon later in this video. Creating a DIY note is a bit different from creating DIY content in the financial statement areas. We will quickly demonstrate how to create a DIY note. First, open the Notes to the Financial Statements library where you want the note to reside. The easiest way to do this is to return back to the Knowledge Library by clicking on the green arrow in the toolbar. I will choose the Notes to the Financial Statements 1. From the Document menu, select Add New Firm Content. The New Content Specification dialog appears. From the drop-down menus, select the Area, Heading, Topic, and if applicable, the subtopic for the note. For each of these, you also have the option to click on the New buttons to the right, where you can manually populate the fields. Refer to our online help to learn more about these fields. In the Name field, name the new note. I will call mine DIY Table. Click OK, and the Knowledge Library dialog appears. In the top pane of the dialog, Expand the sections until you get to the Do-It-Yourself table. Click the radio button for the Do-It-Yourself table and then click OK. The DIY note will be added to the firm library. Now that we've created both a DIY table in a statement and in the notes, we will go ahead and edit one of these tables. The table that we'll edit will be the DIY table inserted into the Additional Statement Area 1. Please note that the editing features in this video are available in DIY notes as well. Navigate to the firm library for the financial statement area that contains the DIY content that you'd like to edit. This will be my Additional Statement Area 1, where I was working earlier. Click anywhere within the DIY table, and from the Section menu or the right-click menu, select Edit Do-It-Yourself Table. In this demonstration, I will edit my table to make it a consolidated statement of income. When the editing mode is enabled, you will see some additional cells. The cells all represent different information. For instance, the topmost pairing of cells display quarterly dates if you're producing a quarterly DIY table. The second set of cells display the reporting dates, while the last two sets of cells contain the predefined rounding and currency options, respectively. In this table, I have two columns, but I would like four numeric columns, two for the parent entity and two for the consolidated balances. To add a column for the prior year for the parent, right-click on the prior year column and select Modify Table. Here you are presented with many options for your table. Select New Column. The column calculation dialog displays. This dialog uses radio buttons and drop-down menus to define the behavior for the specified column. You can define the column type, its attributes, and printing options in this dialog. If at any point you require assistance or would like definitions for these fields, select the Help button for more information. In the Type tab of the dialog, select the entity as parent, and in the Mapping and Grouping Variables tab, set the year to Year 1 Prior Year. Click OK. Notice a new column has been added. The next column inserted will be the current year for the consolidated entity. Again, right-click on the prior year column and select Modify Table, then New Column. In the Type tab of the dialog, choose Consolidated for the entity and keep the default selections in the Mapping and Grouping Variables tab. Click OK. There are now four columns in the table. Now, I want this statement to have two header lines, one that specifies whether the column is the parent or consolidated column, and one that corresponds to the reporting periods for the column, either prior year or current year. To insert a header line, right-click within the header section and select Modify Table, then select New Header Line. The new header will be inserted below the cursor. Delete all of the paragraph markers and move the existing header line below the new header line using the Sort Header Lines option. Right-click in the table and select Modify Table, then select Sort Header Lines. Move the existing header line down one so it is below the new header line. Then click OK. You can now copy the current and prior year header columns to the appropriate blank columns, like so. In the first header line, I want the heading for the parent columns centered over the prior and current year parent columns, and I want the heading for consolidated columns to be centered over the prior year and current year for consolidated columns. This involves using the merge functionality. Merge the first two columns together by selecting Modify Table, then choose to merge either left or right. This will become the column header for the parent. Merge the last two columns this way. This will become the header for the consolidated balances. To insert the text parent and consolidated for the respective column headings, two new CaseView cells need to be inserted. In the parent header area, press Ctrl-L on your keyboard to make a cell. Use the default cell ID and click OK. Set the cell type to alphanumeric. In the calculation properties for this example, the formula for the parent will go in the calculation field. As you can see, the calculated value updates with a preview. Click OK. Repeat these steps for the consolidated balances header, but in the calculation properties, enter the appropriate consolidated formula. The calculated value updates with the preview. Click OK. The heading Parent is now centered over the parent, current, and prior year columns, while the heading Consolidated is centered over the consolidated, current, and prior year columns. With the table columns and headers built, the rows can be mapped using the mapping dropdowns. I will begin by showing you how to map a few rows. The first row item will be mapped to Revenue Trading, and the second to Cost of Sales. I will subtotal these by accessing the section menu and choosing Subtotals, then Add Subtotal. For more information on adding subtotals, please see the QuickVid Financial Statements Subtotals or refer to our online help. Note that you might have to change the row attributes in order to correctly display subtotals in your client file. Continue mapping the table as needed. This is my completed table, which is almost ready to be provided to the users of this template. Once you are done editing a table, lock the DIY table to keep it from being edited within client files. Users will not be able to add or modify columns. They will, however, be able to insert rows. This ensures consistency and will maintain standards across all files. Click within the DIY table from the section menu or the right-click menu, select Modify Table, and then select Lock Do-It-Yourself Table. When you're done with your table, right-click and unselect the Edit Do-It-Yourself Table option. Before we conclude, we want to emphasize that only the basics on creating and editing DIY content and notes have been covered here. We suggest that you refer to our online help for more information on editing, configuring, and managing DIY tables. The detailed online help will also provide you with valuable information to help understand limitations and differences between DIY tables and notes. You should also understand that your DIY tables will not update based on settings in the ribbons like default CaseWare tables, unless you build in this functionality. You can refer to KB713 for additional information. This concludes the QuickVid on do-it-yourself tables in CaseWare Financials. For additional resources, including documentation and online help, see the related links. Thank you for watching CaseWare QuickVids.